Good morning, April 6th, Faith and Funds. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness, the power, and the glory, the victory, and the majesty, for all that is in heaven and in earth is yours. 1 Chronicles chapter 29, verse 11. During the Great Recession that began in 2008, the government injected massive amounts of money, or credit, into the economy in hopes of jumpstarting a recovery. The average citizen wondered, if the government is in debt, where does it get all this new stimulus money? Since ordinary citizens could not create new money, the government stimulus packages were confusing to many. Where did this new money come from? While the technical answer to that question involves the Federal Reserve extending new lines of credit to member banks, there is a spiritual application to be gleaned. However the money was created, measured, or accounted for, God owned it all. The Christian's hope should never ultimately be in the government's ability to change the money supply. Our hope is in the one who accomplishes his purposes on the earth through establishing and removing kings and their policies. After all, Jesus said we cannot serve both God and money. Matthew chapter 6, verse 24. When we serve God, we put our trust for everything, including the money needed to live, in him alone. In the battle of faith, money is usually the last stronghold to fall. Ron Dunn. And with that quote, we are done. See y'all in the evening. See y'all in the evening.
Hey, you hear when the water's gonna come back home? Hey, you hear when the water's gonna come back home? Hey, you hear when the water's gonna come back home?
Good evening, April 6th. Christ's gift to you. But now a righteousness from God, apart from law, has been made known. The righteousness from God comes through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. Romans chapter 3, verses 21 and 22. Many people deny themselves the joy of a life fulfilled in Christ because they are convinced they are not worthy of it. Because of something they have said or done in the past, they believe that they cannot turn to Christ for help, and so they fail to experience Christ's greatest gift to humanity, God's love. The greatest wonder of the Christian faith is that God has chosen you as his own. Nothing except for the fact that you believe in Jesus Christ qualified you for this privilege. His love cannot be earned, and nothing that you do can make you worthy of it. It is God's gift to you, given in abundant grace. If you find it difficult to accept this fact of salvation, just think of the crucifixion of our Savior. A thief who lived in a life of lawlessness and sin was crucified with Jesus, and at the very last moment he turned to Jesus for mercy. And Jesus accepted him into paradise that very day. Regardless of who you are or what your past involves, the love of the living Messiah is God's gift to you. Remember, guys, Christ is the Greek translation of the Hebrew word Mashiach, which is translated into English as Messiah. But since the New Testament was written in Greek, we have transliterated the Greek in most cases rather than the Hebrew. So this is Christ's gift to you. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.